Hey guys, so today it is Tuesday, March 10, 2020, and it is another edition of Meal Subscription. So if you guys are new to my channel, I order these meal subscription boxes here and there, and so I show them to you, and I make the recipes, and I show them, and then I tell you if I like them. And so for this box, I haven't ordered meal subscription for a while from the either two companies that I go with, and so because neither of them had interesting recipes, and so these guys actually had some pretty boring recipes the last few months, so nothing really caught my attention until this week. And so these guys, the plan that I do, it is a 4 meals a week for $89. So that is not too bad. It's like if you have to spend money on food anyways. So this first recipe is pretty simple. Stupid simple. It is a pork sausages with French onion gravy. Looks very self-explanatory and pretty easy. And the next one is, again, pretty easy. Curry chicken sheet pan bake. I really, really like to learn these easy oven recipes, you guys, because I have a very limited kitchen space. And so, very, very nice and helpful. Yeah. So that looks pretty exciting. And then the next one is salmon. I've never had salmon with any of these guys before. The salmon, Greek style salmon over orzo. So it again seems pretty easy, not too challenging. And then the last one is halloumi and veggie Buddha bowl. Again, it's got halloumi cheese again, and this time it's like an Asian style fusion recipe. So there you go. Not too challenging, it doesn't look like. And so they give you these stupid coupons. So these are the bags again. Salmon. Halloumi and veggie Buddha bowl. And then curry chicken sheet pan bake, and then pork sausage with French onion gravy. They loaded up this one pretty good. And then got the Italian sausage. Here's the chicken thighs. And salmon. What the heck? Let me put you guys down for one moment. Yeah, so I do not like these guys at all. Like the other guys, the halloumi cheese, they gave you the whole pack of halloumi cheese. These ones, they just vacuum pack the halloumi cheese. So very not impressed with these guys. I'm not very happy with them. So the portions, the other guys are better, and these guys are the same style, the shitty portions. And so, yep, and so there's the box, and there's the ice pack, you guys. Hi guys, so this is Wednesday, March 10, 2020, so this is the first round of the meal subscription for this week, and so this is the most exciting dish in the whole week, I think. It is this Greek style salmon over orzo. And so I am so excited about this recipe because the only work to do is to cook up the orzo. And the vegetables and everything is all chopped for you. And so yeah, so the only work is to really just to cook the salmon. And the salmon, they even took off the skin for you, which is very nice because I was worried about dealing with that. And so yep, and there's the stuff for the sauce. And so yeah, so really happy with that. And there's this spice blend. All right, you guys. So the salmon dinner is done, and there's the sauce. And so, once again, with these guys, the portions are very small. This is all the food that they give you for two people. And so, but it was a very easy recipe. It was a very fun recipe to do, and so it looks picture perfect. And so basically, it is like mixing the orzo with the vegetables. And so, yeah, so this recipe is very stupid simple. And I'll definitely be doing this one again. Isn't that beautiful, gorgeous? All right, you guys. March 13th, 2020, and so another recipe today. So this is the pork sausages with French onion gravy. So the steps, it seems pretty easy. So the only work seems to be just chopping up the garlic and the onion and the broccoli. And so yeah, and they also include you a salad to this. And the spice blend, you actually use it on the vegetables. And so yeah, so there's a spice blend. It's just a French style dinner, they say. But yeah, so I'm just gonna get chopping, and so I'll be right back, you guys. So here's the pork sausages with French onion gravy. And they actually give you a lot of potatoes under there. And so yeah, not bad. Pretty self-explanatory recipe. And so the only thing different that I did was I used half of the garlic for the gravy and half of the garlic for the salad. And originally they tell you to use all of the garlic for the gravy. So yes, yeah, so because the salad, they do not give you anything else for the salad, just the salad basically. And so so it's pretty boring salad. So yeah, so pork sausages with French onion gravy. Hey guys, so today is Saturday, March 14th, 2020, and so gonna be doing this one. Curry chicken sheet pan bake. So this is the chicken they give you, and then this is all the peppers. Oh my gosh, it's like making a salad. So, and there's the cilantro and other potatoes. There's all the potatoes there. So it's like basically another kind of meat and potatoes kind of recipes. So I'm gonna figure it out, you guys. Look at all those peppers, like, oh my. OMG, you guys, so this dish smells so amazing. It's like the veggies and stuff that they give you is like just the right amount. It's like I was wanting to make some rice or something to go on the side, but the potatoes and veggies is just enough. And this dish smells so amazing and so fancy. It's so beautiful. And so How does that compare? And there's the sauce that goes with it. So what I did was the lime, they say to put half of the lime juice here and half of the lime juice there. And so I just put the entire lime in this juice, and same with the cilantro and the scallions. And they tell me to put half the cilantro here and half the cilantro there, blah blah blah. It's just so annoying. It's like normally I do not mix sauces and stuff, but this is really, really good stuff, you guys. So it's like fancy, fancy home cooking, you guys. So curry chicken sheet pan bake. So this one is a success. So I really like this one, and I will be definitely making this one in the future, you guys. So really beautiful dish, you guys. Hey guys, so today it is Tuesday, March 17, 2020, and so this is the last recipe that I'm doing for this week. This halloumi and veggie Buddha bowl. And so I left it till the last day, the week, and so the only thing that went very sad is this green onion. Hello, green onion. Hello. So, this very sad looking green onion, so I'm just gonna do without that. And so, this recipe has gai lan, this Asian greens, and so it's a very hearty one, so it's good. And it's like they gave you some carrots here, they say. Like, seriously, just one of them, and I swear this is a parsnip. This is not a carrot. What do you guys think, you guys? Is this a parsnip or this is a carrot? They gave you the wrong thing. And like, honestly, the picture, they look like so much carrots, but it's like they just give you one. Like, what the heck? And so they say to roast this carrots, but I'm not gonna waste my energy to do that. And so I am just gonna fry up the gai lan and this thingamajiggy together. And so that is what I'll do. And so the only work, it seems, is to do the rice. And so, yeah, and this is the packaging for the peanut butter. They don't even label it, it's peanut butter. But, oh well. So, yeah, alright, you guys. Hey guys, so here's this, halloumi and veggie Buddha bowl done. And so yeah, so I am not very impressed with the portions for this one, and there's the sauce there, and I am sure that they gave me a parsnip instead of carrots. Like, there's a difference there, right? That's a carrot in the picture, and that is what they gave me. And I am just excited for the halloumi cheese. I just love it. And so, this is like a weird Asian fusion sort of dish. It's weird. So, yeah, so this is just some lunch. And then I'll be waiting for the next box, you guys. All right. Today it is Tuesday, March 17, 2020. And so, I finished all my meal subscription recipes for this past week. All of these ones here. And so the recipes this week was pork sausages with French onion gravy. That's the one of them. And then the next one is this Greek style salmon orzo thing, the salmon dish. And then, so the next one is this halloumi and veggie Buddha bowl, this thing here. And then the last one is this curried chicken sheet pan bake. So those are the four recipes this week. And so let me tell you guys my favorite recipe for this week first. And so I actually really, really like this curried pan, the chicken sheet pan bake.
And so they actually make everything in the one pan, and the flavors are amazing. The curry flavors are delicious, and so I really enjoy curry flavors. And so the only thing I don't get is with the edamame peas. I don't know why they got the edamame peas there, but the roasted peppers was, oh my gosh, it was delicious. I really enjoyed that. So I am gonna be like making my own curry spice blend for this if I ever make this. And so this is definitely gonna be on the to-do list again. And so this one is the curry chicken sheet pan bake. And so I really like this everything in one pan recipes. And yeah. And then the one that I really didn't care about this week is this halloumi and vegetable. It's just the portions was very small and stuff like that. And I swear they gave me a parsnip instead of a carrot. And so it was okay, but it's just a weird recipe. Like, I do not understand the Asian and fusion recipe like this. Like, I don't understand it. So I will be most likely not getting this recipe again. And so for this salmon dish, this recipe actually gave me a new idea to serve with orzo. And so they toast the veggies on the frying pan, and then they toss the veggies and orzo together. So whenever the grocery store is stocked again on produce, like, I'm gonna be trying to make this orzo recipe again. And so they gave me a new idea to serve orzo. So I'm very, very happy about that. And so very easy recipe, and I like it. And so the last one is this pork sausage one. It is a very self-explanatory dish. It's like a meat and potatoes dish and stuff like that. But very easy to execute. And so, yeah. And so, for me, normally the Italian sausage is very dry, but I don't know. Like, I probably made it correctly this time. And so, the pork sausage was nice and juicy and stuff like that. So, yeah. So, this is just your basic meat and potatoes recipe. So, yeah. And so, there's the four recipes for this week. And so, I had some very nice cooking. Everything was easy. And none of the recipes went bad besides the one green onion. And yeah. So, stay tuned for next week. And so, because the way with the grocery store crazy things going on, I'm probably gonna be doing the next few weeks of the meal subscription. So at least I have some food in the house here. So yeah, so thank you so much for tuning in today, guys, and don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel, and I will see ya in the next one.